Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 7 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. In the last episode, we began our character creation journey by building the character's head. In this episode, we'll create the body. Following this episode will be a few installments that will include rigging, character movement, and how to add some personality to your character. We'll also go over using DUIK, a free character rigging plugin. Today, we're going to focus on giving our head a body. I'll be creating this in a way that will give you options for movement as you continue with your own character. There's a lot to get to, so let's dive right in. Okay, so this is the head that we created last week. Let's grab all of these layers, go to layer, and let's pre-compose these, and let's name this head. You want to be able to put different heads on some of these bodies, so that way you can change out your look for your character or have multiple characters in the same scene. We want to add the body to this, so let's just move our head up, and let's go into our composition settings, increase our height to about 2,000. That way we have some room to play around with, and everything will be in proportion. We want to create some shape layers and make sure that you label these. And we're also going to give them their own specific color. And don't forget, we also have our color control over here. So we want to bring that up, and we want to lock this down so we can come back to it as we go through our character and begin to color it in. Right click, new shape layer. We'll call this neck, a simple rectangle with a fill. Option click our color, and we're going to choose our skin layer. Position this where it needs to be. This is going to go underneath our head layer, and just kind of play with the settings. I like to kind of round this out also. Okay, now let's right click, new shape layer, and let's call this layer body. And our body layer is going to go underneath our head layer, but above our neck layer. And this is just going to be a rectangle, and we can add a fill. Option click our color, and I'm going to bring this to our shirt layer. Uncheck the rectangle path size. Just kind of play with this to get it the right size. Okay, and let's kind of round this out so he has some shoulders. And now let's create a new shape layer, and we'll call this upper arm. And this is going to be a rectangle and a fill. And again, with this fill, we're going to option click our color and grab our shirt color up here. This is going to connect to our shoulder. And now what's really important here is where your anchor point is. For your arms and your legs specifically, you need the anchor points to be in very specific places. We're going to go for the top center, so that way our anchor point is right here. Hit Y for the pan behind tool. I'm going to move it down just slightly so it's about right there. Click R to bring up your rotation. You can see everything is going to move from that point there. P for our position, and we're just going to move this over. Now, if we duplicate this upper arm, it's going to bring over our fill that's connected to our shirt layer. Control D or Command D if you're on Mac, and we want to change that to lower arm. And then let's just bring up P for our position, and let's bring it down so it connects somewhere around here, close to our elbow. And now we just need to make a few adjustments for the size of this. So the forearm is going to be a little bit shorter than the upper arm. Reposition our anchor point. Kind of mess with this rotation to kind of see how it's going to rotate around. That actually looks pretty good. Let's add a group and put that rectangle and fill in there. And then let's add one more group, bring it to the top. We're going to call this new group cuff, and our group that we just created, shirt sleeve. And then in the cuff group, let's add a rectangle and a fill. And for this fill, option click our color and grab the shirt highlight. Let's uncheck this, move our position down. If you click Y with the panorama tool, I like to just have my anchor point for even for these groups within my shape layers. I like to center everything. Right click, new shape layer. And this is going to be his hand. And for hand, let's add one group, name this palm, add an ellipse and a fill. Option click our color and grab our skin. Just kind of bring it over and position it underneath the cuff. And just make sure that this layer is underneath your lower arm layer, like that. And just kind of play with it to get it the right size that you're looking for. And then let's duplicate this palm layer. I affected the ellipse size more egg-shaped. Let's name this thumb. And we need the size to be the same. So let's make that maybe 85 by 85. And let's change our fill here to our skin highlight. Moving it around to where I think looks okay. And you may or may not like that. Actually, I'm going to change this back to just our skin color. Highlight, lower arm, hand, and upper arm. And let's just change this color to orange. So that way we know all three of these go together. Whenever you move this upper arm, you want everything to move with it. As of right now, it just moves by itself. Parent your lower arm to the upper arm, and then parent the hand to the lower arm. It goes from the extremity up. So hand gets parented to lower arm gets parented to upper arm, and upper arm gets parented to body. So now see if we move this around, everything goes with it. If you go to your lower arm and hit bring up your rotation, you can see you can also move this without it moving your upper arm. So you just want everything to be parented the right way. And let's grab these three layers and duplicate those. Move all the new layers above the ones we had. And let's just change this color to green. So let's get these left and right labels. So our lower arm, let's call this left lower arm. Hand is going to be left hand. And upper arm is going to be left upper arm. These are the ones we just created that are new. So we're going to call this right lower arm, right hand, and right upper arm. So all we need to do to make this a right arm is if you right click on right upper arm layer, go to transform, flip horizontal. Just have to kind of play with the position and rotation, but you'll see that now we have a right arm. And it's built exactly the same way. You want things to be as symmetrical as possible. New shape layer, call this belt, add a rectangle, and add a fill. So if you highlight glasses, duplicate that layer. Let's just name this accessories. So for accessories for right now, I'm going to kind of go with maybe a brown. For our fill, for our belt layer, option click our color, and we'll choose accessories. Let's bring up our position and the transform properties for this layer. Let's unlink our size. Just kind of play with this so that way we kind of cover up the curve. And actually, let's add a group, rectangle and fill in there, and we'll call this strap. And then we can add another group, bring it above our strap layer, call that buckle. Let's add a rectangle and add a stroke. Duplicate our accessory layer. This will just be accessories too. So maybe make it kind of like a goldish color. Option click color in our stroke, and we'll go with accessories too. Increase our stroke width, make this smaller. There's our belt. Create a new shape layer, left upper leg, add a rectangle and add a fill. And for this fill, we're going to option click our color, and we want to go with pants. Open up our transform properties and bring it down. And we're going to kind of play with our rectangle path settings. Unlink our size, our X and Y. I'm going to use the move anchor point script and just go for the top center again, around there. Let's make this a little bit shorter. And now let's duplicate this layer. Let's change the name, left lower, and we're just going to move that down. I'm going to change the size of our rectangle path, make it a little bit shorter. Again, move this up to the top center. As you can see, he's kind of going off of our screen here. So let's hit Command A. And now make sure these layers that are already parented, you want to not include those. And just grab one of these layers positions and you can move it up and everything should move up together just fine. Let's give this layer some roundness. Just kind of round that out a little bit. Do the same thing with the left upper leg. I'm going to parent our lower leg to our left upper leg. Bring up our rotation on this upper leg. See, that doesn't look quite right, so let's move our anchor point to about where the knee would be, somewhere like right around there, and reposition. There we go. So something like that for now. Add a group, put the rectangle and fill in there. We'll call this pants leg. Add another group, call that cuff. Move this above our pants leg layer and add a rectangle and a fill. And for a fill, let's option click the color and use our pants highlight. Pull this down and kind of play with the settings here. Another shape layer, call this shoe. And for this, we'll make this a rectangle and a fill. And for a fill, we want to option click the color, choose our shoes layer here, and just bring this down to where the foot would be. Make sure that your shoe is underneath your lower leg. Actually, let's go ahead and call this left shoe. Unlink our size so we can kind of make it wider, give it some roundness. I'm going to kind of keep this one a little simple. If you want to add in an ellipse, now it's going to have the same fill that your rectangle has. So all you have to really kind of do is mess around with the placement of it. And you can kind of give them, you know, something like a toe. Maybe let's duplicate that rectangle path, move it over, and let's move our anchor point up to the top right, bring up our scale for the shoe overall, and just kind of shrink that down a little bit. So we have something kind of like that. First, let's go ahead and highlight these layers and give this another color. I'll go with fuchsia. And we want to link our shoe to our lower leg, and our lower leg is already linked to our upper leg. And then link our upper leg to our body. Oh, by the way, let's go ahead and link our belt to our body too. Let's highlight these three layers, duplicate those, move the new layers above. Go ahead and change the color to maybe green. Right click on upper left upper leg 2 and go to transform, flip horizontal, and then just bring up our position on our left upper leg 2. And let's go ahead and change these to right upper leg, right shoe, right lower leg. The way you have these legs positioned is going to depend on what you want to do with the character. We'll see why that's important in another episode. He's good for like forward-facing movements like waves and things like that. But if you want him to walk, we have to make some other adjustments. Things like the way his arms are placed, the way his face looks, and the way his legs are placed. But we will get to that in another episode. The right upper leg and left upper leg, both highlighted. Let's bring up our scale and just decrease the size of those a little bit. So that's not too bad. We do need to add in a waist. New shape layer, we'll call this waist. We will add a rectangle and a fill. Option click the color and grab his pants. Just want to make sure that the waist is underneath your body layer. So let's move this down. You want to span the waist, but you also want it to have where it doesn't intrude too much into your legs. Increase our roundness on this. Maybe move it down a little bit. I'm going to give him a V-neck. So if you grab your pen tool and make sure that you click the tool creates mask, it defaults to this tool create shape, but we want to put a mask on the shape layer. So make sure this tool creates mask right here is checked. And we want to subtract that mask, not add it. And just kind of play with our mask here, just so his neck goes into his shirt just a little bit. As I mentioned before, you can change these colors anytime you'd like. For example, make this a yellow shirt. Grab our shirt color for the highlight and kind of darken it. Maybe you want the pants like a green. Bring your pants highlight, select the pants color, and then just darken it. Shoes to be a different color. So this makes it super easy to change your settings. So for right now, this is what we have, and we will be doing some rigging next week. And then I'm also going to show you how to use DUIK following that. And then I'm going to show you some tricks on how to take these characters and give them a lot of personality in the way they move. And before you know it, you will be creating these all on your own and making them look really, really sweet. I'm including the project files below, so you can grab those and play around with this character and practice making your own unique body parts. Thanks for watching. See you next time.